नसेंट्स विल सी मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड्स. सो बेसिकली वी डिवाइड द ऑब्जेक्ट्स और थिंग्स इंटू टू पार्ट्स, दैट इज इलास्टिक बॉडी एंड सेकेंड इज प्लास्टिक बॉडी. ओके, ऑन विच वी हैव बी डिवाइडेड. एक्चुअली इलास्टिक बॉडीज आर दोज इन विच वेन एवर वी अप्लाइड फोर्स दिस शोज द डिफॉर्मेशन इन द शेप. Till that time, when we applied the force, if we remove that force, they come at their original shape or size. Okay, what are the plastic bodies? Plastic bodies are those in which if we applied force little bit, they show permanent deformation in the shape. Okay, that are the plastic bodies. Okay, now here we are going to study about the elastic bodies. First of all, let me make you know, neither any body is purely elastic, neither anybody is purely plastic. Okay, after certain amount of force, every elastic body also shows plasticness. Plasticness means they shows permanent deformation. Okay, so we are going to study about the elastic bodies. Okay, so for studying the elastic bodies, we have to know two things. Stress is basically the physical quantity which is the ratio of force upon area. Okay, why it is necessary? We applied stress on a body for knowing the elasticity of that. And another is strain. Strain is change in dimension upon original dimension. Original dimension, change in dimension upon original dimension. Okay, so let me see how many types of stress. Stress has basically three types. First is longitudinal stress. Second is tangential stress. And third is bulk stress. Third is bulk stress is also called volume stress. Okay, and how many types of strain? Strain is also three types. Okay, first longitudinal strain, shearing strain, and volumetric strain. Now we are going to see about all of them. Okay, so firstly we are going to see about the Hooke's law. What is Hooke's law? So before knowing the Hooke's law, we have to know what is the relation and what we understand by stress or strain. Basically stress is what? Now suppose that if I am saying I have a, just for making you know simply, this is a rubber, okay, and this is the circular area of rubber. If I am applying force on this area, okay, so it will increase the length of this. Okay. Suppose that it has original length capital L and increment in length is small l. Okay, so what is strain? Strain is how much change in dimension take place, how much change in length take place, is small l. What is the original length? That is capital L. Okay, what is stress? Basically stress is force upon area. So area we assume like it is not that much very means that not that much contract. So if we increase the force, or if you observe, so if suppose that area is decrease also, so in denominator area decrease, it means when stress increases, so which thing increase? A small l, that is change in length or change in dimension increase. As much as we increase the force, stress increase, small l increase. It means what? Which thing is increase? Strain. So Hooke says that stress is directly proportional to strain. Stress is directly proportional to strain. Okay. But within elastic limit. Why I'm writing within elastic limit? Because of the reason that if we are applying too much stress, so this rubber shows after some time permanent change. We don't want permanent change. If permanent change occur, it means at that time permanent strain occur. Okay, so at that time Hooke's law is violated. Okay, so stress is directly proportional to strain within elastic limit, means we are applying stress till that amount when it is the body is able to retain its shape again. Okay, stress is directly proportional to strain. When we remove this proportionality, then there is a constant term that we say E. And somewhere in many other books by another thing they had noted, E is, we are assuming, elasticity constant. Somewhere it is written coefficient of elasticity. Okay, so don't be confused, elasticity constant and coefficient of elasticity. Now we are going to further study about this chapter. Whenever we draw the graph between elasticity, between stress and strain. Now suppose that, so this is stress and this is strain. I'm going to draw the graph between stress and strain. Okay, so when I'm going to draw the graph of stress and strain, so I'm stretching a rubber, so it easily stretch initially. Okay, so when it easily stretch, and if we left from that state, so it's always come at the same position. So that point is called, till this point I'm stretch, it's this A is point is called proportionality limit. Quite later I will make you understand each and everything. Proportional limit. Okay, further I am trying to stretch more, so it's from its capacity increase little bit more. This point is called B. Further, if we want to, at this state, if we are releasing the upper object or rubber anything, so it always come at the same position, means strain again become zero, means it's able to come at the original shape. Okay, so this point is called final point, or we'll say yield point. Yield point is that point if we release the object or rubber, anything that is elastic, from that state, so it always come at their original shape. But further, if we want to stretch more, suppose that I'm stretching more, it come at the point C. At this point, when you applied more stress, at this point particle shows, now if we release from this state, then a permanent strain will come. Okay, if we observe, if any rubber is there, suppose that in air there is any rubber. Okay, if I am elongating too, so after limit when I am elongating, so I am observing like this type of shape will come. The rubber is going to be thin and this type of shape will come, like this type of edges come. Okay, that is called because of permanent. So if we release from this state, so what we get? A permanent strain come. That is OO dash we'll say. Okay. Now further, if we am applying force, so at this time, continuously a object shows plastic behavior. It means now these changes are coming permanently. Now at this point D. D is not D, it shows anything, object and rubber shows ultimate tensile strength. Means after D point, if you reduce the stress or decrease your force until after that, means if you decrease the force, still that it shows a permanent change, or it shows a permanent change in the shape. Okay, if we reduce the force till that, and E is called fracture point. E is called fracture point. At this point, now rubber is totally break. Okay, so I'm making you understand this graph by taking one example. Now suppose that I have this rubber. Okay, I'm applying force on this. So this rubber is elongate. Okay, I'm continuously increasing this force. Okay, elongate. So if till this point, means it reaches at A. If I'm releasing this rubber, so it's come at the original shape. Okay, now further I'm increasing more little bit after increasing the stress or force. So at this point, this is point B. Until this rubber becomes thin, too much thin. Again, if we release from here, so it's going to be its original shape. But still we are going to apply force. So it's become too much thin. Okay. And it is at come at the condition C. Continuously increase the force. Okay. Now it at this time, if we release, so permanent change in shape occur. It means might be we release from here, so it's not come on the same shape of this, it's come on this shape. Okay, permanent change in shape occur. Now further, if I am going to increase, okay, means at till D point. What I'm saying, what we are feeling here, a small like is rubber starts doing like this, means these edges are coming in rubber. Okay, after that, if we applied force or reduce this force, okay, F4 times dash, reduce this force. Still it's going to be at the from mid, it's like start breaking, and here from here it's start breaking after D it starts breaking, and at a time when force is continuously increased, time will come when it's break from here. So that is called fracture point. Okay, now we'll see. Now we'll see Young's modulus of elasticity. What is Young's modulus of elasticity? Now suppose that whenever we observe change in dimension, yeah, anything change in dimension comparatively more in length rather than breadth or height. So we'll say we are studying about the Young's modulus of elasticity. Now suppose that I have a rod of original length L. Okay, now this rod, due to its own weight, that is mg, elongate slightly, that is small l. Okay, so what we observe, its radius be r and force mg length l. So what is stress? Now look, this stress is perpendicular to the surface. This force is perpendicular to the surface, so we'll say it's normal stress or longitudinal stress, that is force upon area. What which thing is doing the work of force? Mg. So what we write? Mg by pi r square. Okay, now what is the longitudinal? The strain is come in length, so what is the longitudinal strain? This is known as stress, also called longitudinal stress. Longitudinal strain, that is small l by capital L. Now we know that from the Hooke's law, normal stress directly proportional to longitudinal strain. Okay, so mg by pi r square is directly proportional to L by L. So if we study about the length, so there is a constant come, that constant is called Young's modulus and denoted by Y, L by L. So how we know the value of Young's modulus? Y is equal to what? MgL pi R square L. This is the Young's modulus. Okay, now we are going to see shearing stress and shearing strain. Okay, we'll see in next lecture. Okay.